Hey guys, today let's take a look at the so-called Warangal Gates. In my last video, we saw that these ancient structures are not entrances or gates. So let's try to understand why these were built. Most experts haven't really examined these structures, but we are going to look at them carefully. On the very top of this gate, there is a straight slot, almost a laser-cut slot right in the middle, and you can see the sun shining through it. Initially, I thought this was a sculptor's mistake, but this slot has been created intentionally on all four gates, and we do see them on east, west, north, and south gates. But they're not identical. On top of these gates, you can see these keyhole-like openings. The position of these slots are made on different keyholes on different gates. Let's start from the east side gate, and here you can see that this slot is made on the fourth keyhole from the left. The position of the slot is at 3.5 keyholes or 3.5. Now, if you go to the exact opposite structure on the other end, the west side gate has a slot on the third hole from the left, not on the fourth hole as in the east gate. So the position of the slot at the west gate is 2.5. Now remember, I'm observing everything from the center of the site. And if you see the east and the west gate side by side, this is how they look. They're not identical. The position of the slots are different. Of course, experts will argue that these are simple mistakes made by primitive sculptors and have no meaning at all. But I will show you why experts are wrong. Now, let's go to the gate on the north side. And again, the straight slot is at the fourth keyhole or at 3.5. If you look at the opposite gate at the south side, the slot appears on the third keyhole or 2.5. So you can see the pattern like this. The east and west are 3.5 and 2.5, and the north and south are again 3.5 and 2.5. What is the meaning of this complex pattern? This proves that there is something fundamentally wrong about our history books. We are not evolved from a primitive civilization into a much more advanced civilization over many centuries. Instead, the more we look at ancient sites, the more we realize that our generation does not have the capability to understand what they were doing. But we are looking at these gates from the human point of view, and we are observing these gates from the center of the site. If you pretend that you are a giant and these gates were small Lego blocks, you would stand outside the site and look at them from one direction. If you go outside the site and look at the east gate, you suddenly realize that the slot is at 2.5 and not 3.5. Now, if we look at both east and west gates from the outside, standing at any one point, these slots are actually identical. Again, if you go outside the north side, for example, and look at both north and south gates, the position of the slots will be the same. The entire confusion of these slots at the third or fourth keyhole occurs because we are looking at it from the human point of view, standing in the center of this massive site. These gates are all designed to be exactly 33 feet tall, and are positioned at the exact cardinal directions. Now, if I go outside the eastern gate and shine a laser beam parallel to the ground through the slot, the beam would pass exactly through the slot on the western gate. Of course, there would be a particular day in the year when the sun rises and a beam of light would pass through the slot on the east and exit through the slot on the western gate. We would have to have astronomers calculate this particular day and its importance. If we place a long pole between these slots on the eastern gate and western gate and place another pole between the north and south gates, these poles would meet at the center of the site and create four quadrants. And these poles would cast shadows on the ground, which can tell time down to the accuracy of seconds and could also be used as a calendar with various features. India does have many of these giant astronomical instruments in places like Jantar Mantar, for example. These instruments are very large and are based on ancient Vedic texts. We could make an extremely advanced instrument on this site because there are so many different features carved on these structures, and it's hard to understand what they stand for. For example, you can see seven buds for 7 days of the week, and there are six keyholes, half for each month of the year, and pay special attention to how some keyholes are partially closed and some are open. These details also differ between the gates. Now, keep in mind that there are northern and southern gates as well, and imagine how they would have been used. And these structures go beyond mere astronomical purposes. What's really fascinating is that these gates have statues of birds standing on their sides. These birds are made of material different from the rest of the structures. They're made of green basalt, a special type of rock. All the gates have these birds, but the north gate doesn't have these birds. The spots are left empty. And what's interesting is that green basalt has some very strong magnetic properties. Why were these magnetic birds not placed on the north gate alone? I'm sure you can examine these aspects yourself. The geometry and the numbers on the site also have some baffling sacred aspect to them. Why was the number 33 chosen as the height of these structures? Researchers of ancient mysteries know that the number 33 is very important. There are 33 vertebrae in our spine. There are 33 gods called Trayathrimshat in Vedic texts. In the Western world, the number 33 has many strange connections, including 33 years in the life of Jesus Christ, and the ancient Freemason system uses 33 degrees and so on. Now, the distance between the eastern and western gates is 433 feet, and the distance between the north and the south gates is 480 feet. This seems like nothing, but the ratio of these distances gives 1 is to 1.108, which is again a sacred ratio to Hinduism. Of course, these are just some of the basics of sacred geometry found in the site, and there's a lot of advanced information embedded on these structures. But this video just gives you a basic idea about these so-called Warangal gates. I think it is time to stop mentioning them as gates and start thinking of them as advanced devices or instruments. What do you think? Please leave your thoughts in the comment section. I'm Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and I will talk to you soon. Bye.